May 14th, let's bring in Kim Emerson, OmniBC and city legislative reporter, to talk about today. Kim, what do voters need to know?
Go out and vote. I mean, if you're a voter, if you're not, you know, apathy laden, go out and vote. And what you need to know is you need to take two pieces of identification with you. You had earlier today on your show that little yellow card, which is, it's not a voting card, but it's a where-to-go card. And they mean that in a polite way. And so you just take a couple of pieces of ID. You can go to your polling station, or you can go to any polling station in the entire province of BC and cast your ballot for the person that you want to win in your particular riding. So they've made it really, really easy to get out and vote. We are, however, restricted in some of the things that we can say on this particular day.
Right. There's no campaigning today. What are the leaders up to today?
Well, the leaders, I mean, I imagine Adrian Dix is going to be sleeping. He just got off his bus at 8 o'clock this morning. He had his 24-hour bus trip around the province of BC, 14 different stops. Christy Clark had a very busy day as well. I would imagine she'll be getting some rest. In past years, premiers have gone out and played tennis with some members of the legislative press gallery. Mike Harcourt did that. Gordon Campbell did that. But these days, I think the premier will be resting. Adrian Dix will be resting. And then it will be nervous time for them, probably from about 4:30 or 5 o'clock on, because no matter what anybody thinks, when it's not in your control, it becomes nervous time for you about, oh my goodness, are the voters actually going to get out and vote for us? Are they going to put us back into government? Or are they going to put us into government? So it's really nervous time this afternoon and then right through until about 9 or 9:30 when we find out what the results will be.
Interesting here. Let people know who tallies the votes and when can we maybe expect results?
Well, yeah, there's literally thousands of volunteers that go out to polling stations and take ballots, show you how to put them into ballot boxes. And then there are scrutineers who watch the vote counting go on. And then you've got all of these scrutineers, all of these volunteers, everybody working as fast as they can, because everyone knows the results are important and they want the results as quickly as possible. Now, there are opportunities to dispute some ballots when they come in. For instance, if they have two names on the ballot instead of just one, you would pull that ballot aside and take a look at it. But for the most part, it's volunteers that do all of this stuff on your behalf.
Wow, that's brilliant. Now, a little known fact you can clarify for us. We love it when you put things into layman's terms. Right now, Christy Clark is the premier of our province. If she does not win tonight, does the new leader immediately become premier?
Nope.
How does it work?
Christy Clark is the premier tonight. Christy Clark is the premier tomorrow. Christy Clark will be the premier on this coming weekend as well. What has to happen is the lieutenant governor has to have a meeting. Once the vote results are in, and if there is a clear winner, she will then invite that leader to form a government for the people of BC. And once they sign the documentation, then Christy Clark is no longer the premier. So if she does not win tonight, and I'm not just talking about her seat, but if she does not win, her party does not win, both she and cabinet remain in place until the new premier and new cabinet ministers are sworn in. But yeah, it takes a few days. There's a couple of week kind of lag here where everything kind of gets sorted out. But yeah, the lieutenant governor gets involved at this point, and she will invite whoever forms the government to do that.
Political lessons, compliments of the one and only Kim Emerson, OmniBC legislative reporter. Thanks for being here, Kim.
You're welcome.